Hi all, and welcome to my channel. So welcome to episode 2 of Your Captain Speaking. I hope you enjoyed the first one, and thank you very much for all new subscriptions. So today we'll be talking about the phenomena called Coffin Corner. So most of you probably heard about it, but some of you might still not know what is it. So basically, in the simplest words, that's the situation in which the airplane is flying too fast and too slow at the same time. But if you want to talk about it in detail, we have to understand a couple of things. So the coffin corner is a situation when the speed margin between a low speed buffet and high speed buffet is approaching zero. So let's say we're flying at flight level, let's say 380, in an empty airplane, as we talked about the previous video. So the margin between high speed buffet and low speed buffet will be massive. It's almost 60 knots. That's a lot of margin you have. But if you're flying the same altitude with a full airplane, which is waiting around 70 tons, let's say, the margin would be about, let's say, 10 to 15 knots. That's really, really narrow one. So what's the reason of that? We have to understand that we have two limitations. One is limiting us from the above, and the other one from the below. The one from above is Mach critical speed, and the one from below is stall speed. So talking first about the stall speed. So you know the airplane is always stalling for given weight, and given airplane will stall at the same angle of attack, which basically means that we stall at the same IAS. That's important. IAS indicated airspeed. So as we're climbing, the air density is decreasing, and the true airspeed for a given IAS, if we climb at the same IAS, the true airspeed is getting higher, so the stall speed is getting higher as well. So as we're climbing, the margin from below is decreasing, and as you see on the clips, as we're passing through higher altitudes and flight levels, it's getting higher and higher and higher. So the other thing limiting us is high speed buffet. To understand that, we have to understand what Mach number is. So Mach number is actually speed of an object compared to speed of sound in the medium we're flying through. So I would say, in other words, that's the speed of an airplane compared to the local speed of sound. So what is actually limiting us? So the thing that is limiting us is actually Mach critical speed. Mach critical, or Mach crit as is often referred to, is a speed at which the airflow at over any point of the airplane will reach speed of sound. And that's usually the top of the wing. So if we take the airfoil and it's moving across the air, the airflow over the wing will increase the speed until eventually reaching speed of sound. So for instance, if we take a 737, the maximum speed is Mach 0.82. So that means that if a 737 is traveling with speed of 82% of speed of sound, there will be an airflow over the wing that will reach Mach 1. So that's actually creating the shockwave, which is creating additional drag, buffeting, vibration, and other things. So that's the short video. You can see the shockwave created and the buffeting, which is caused by it.
Here, slowed up about 40 times, is a Schlieren picture of what may happen to an aileron as a result of shockwaves.
So that's the reason we cannot exceed Mach critical speed. So as we're climbing, the temperature is decreasing, so the local speed of sound is decreasing as well. So as you see on the clips, the maximum speed for 737 is 340 knots or 0.82 Mach. So initially at low altitudes, we can easily climb at 330 knots, and then as we're climbing, the red bar on the top is going down until eventually creating very narrow slot. So, knowing that, we can finally explain what the Coffin Corner is. So, as we are climbing at constant IS, you can see that the stall speed is actually increasing, but our Mach number limitation is decreasing. So eventually we get to the point at which we have either very narrow margin or we have no margin at all. As you see, when we're flying close to Coffin Corner, the margin is getting really narrow, but it's not impossible to fly there. So this situation is basically most dangerous when turning or if flying in the turbulence. Obviously, if we start to turn, the drag is increasing and then we need additional power to overcome it. But we might be power limited, so the airplane will just slow down and get to the airspeed low situation. On the other hand, if you're flying to the turbulence, it might get you into overspeed or underspeed within seconds. So, some of you might ask why the speed tape sometimes is solid red and sometimes is amber. So obviously, solid red, it's indicated something that is happening. So overspeed, actual overspeed or stall. But the amber one is indicating 1.3 G maneuver margin. So if you will fly at the amber band with load factor less than 1.3 G, you are still protected. So that means if you're flying in a level flight or in a bank angle less than 40 degrees, it is still kind of protecting you, but you can hit the turbulence or obviously bank a bit more and then you're not protected anymore. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you very much. I hope I did explain everything well. If you like my channel, hit subscribe on the bottom, and I wish you all the best out of sunny Palma, Mallorca today. Thank you very much and stay tuned.